This video has subtitles. Please, turn them on if you need it.
We don't have to do this.
After all we've been through, it can't be for nothing.
Last of Us Part 1 has finally made it to PC. No more wasting all the computer resources for a barely crawling emulation of PlayStation 3. Look at this detailization, wow. Well, a look at this utilization, oof. As you know, unfortunately, the release of PC version turned out to be disappointing. You can already understand this from a main menu, whereas such useful thing as shader compilation takes half an hour on a Ryzen 3016 overclocked to 4.2 GHz. And at the same time, the game still continues to intensively load all processor cores and dropping the frame rate in a most ordinary game since. Of course, the biggest game problem is the appetite for memory. 16GB of RAM and 8GB of VRAM, just not enough for this game. As players, we have no control over these memory consumption issues and related crashes. But we can significantly improve our gaming experience by doing something that developers probably will not fix in the near future, or at all.
You mumble in your sleep. I hate bad dreams.
This is not another guide to finding out optimized graphical settings. There is plenty of that on YouTube. But if you want and you have similar hardware, you can try my graphical settings for RTX 3016 with 20GB of VRAM. I'm not trying to squeeze all the possible FPS of my system, but I try to keep detailed picture at 16 frames per second on my 4K display. So if you want, you can have it. First of all, the most expensive graphic option, of course, resolution. None of graphics settings affect frame rate as much as number of pixels the graphic cards needs to render. It would seem that everything is simple here. Use the native resolution of your display to clearly display the game HUD or interface or something, and just adjust render resolution with the slider in the options, or use DLSS or FSR. But here lies another problem of a bad PC port. Standard anti-aliasing looks really bad. On one hand, it blurs the edges of the object that must be sharp. On the other, it does not smooth out small details that should not be too sharp. Like here. In that case, why just not use DLSS? Yes, Nvidia upscaling is very good, but not everyone has an RTX series graphics card to enable it. And this video is for everyone, I believe. Besides, in this game DLSS lost its ultra-performance option, which normally allows you to upscale the image 3 times, so the minimum resolution for 4K in performance mode is 1080p, which shows less than 60fps in most scenes in my configuration. So FSR it is, and there is ultra-performance here, and it looks awful in this game. The static picture is clear, but as soon as I turn the camera at any upscale quality setting, fine details as grass or these fences just begin to crumble into pixels. That's not good. I cannot understand how this can be shipped as final game. It's the first thing we can fix. As DLSS, FSR libraries can be replaced with versions from other games. I leave link to these DLLs in video description. As you can see, after replacing FSR libraries, fine details no longer crumble in motion and image looks much better than with standard anti-aliasing. For my monitor at 4K, I use Ultra Performance mode, which upscales game from 720p 3 times. But for 2K and 1080p monitors, I recommend using Balanced and Quality modes, respectively. Next comes an option that you should not use in any case. This game frame limiter. Yes, we already use it to know that built-in frame rate limiters are often not so good and outputting unstable frame time. But in this case, everything is much worse. For example, your game is running at average of 67 FPS, but this value varies from scene to scene from 55 to 17. And you want to lock the frame rate at 16, so that most of the time game runs at 1 level of smoothness. Don't do it in game options. When you turn on these settings to a value below your current performance level, load on CPU for some reason increases. In my case, it increases by 5-7%, and this game is already very demanding on CPU resources, so this option must be turned off by setting it to unlimited. If you want to limit FPS without problems, use for example RivaTuner statistics server. Surprisingly, in this game, in addition to usual graphics settings that significantly affect FPS, such as quality of shadows, etc., there are also options that, when turned on, should not reduce frame rate in any way. But they really are. Chromatic aberration usually does not reduce FPS at all, but in this game it lowers FPS by 1 from 60, so it's 3% of performance loss. Also, motion blur usually does not affect performance too much, but in this game, even on lowest quality settings, during the rain, it reduces performance by 4 FPS. Probably it applies to everything, like animated textures, water drops or vegetation, even if player does not rotate the camera and characters stand still. So turn off these two options and you have 5 more FPS, or I believe it's 10%. Yeah, 10% of performance. At the moment, it's all that I managed to do to improve my experience in Last of Us Part 1 on PC. Of course, be sure to install the latest patches and video card drivers. If I find something else, I will write it in a pinned comment under the video, and also duplicate it in my Discord channel. If this video was informative for you, you can leave me a like, or a money, for coffee. Thank you for watching.